Alright, so in this video, I'm going to show you how I do patina lettering. I know a lot of people have a lot of different ways of doing it. First, I, you know, come up with a design to scale the doors. Then I use Cerule paper to transfer it. And I know you can barely see, but it's enough for me to be able to reference. Creamy color for the letters. Reducer, and I have tape ones off too to make sure I have a nice crisp edge. And I usually start from the bottom and work up. I want to kind of palette it too, real thin. Just kind of touch down, drag up. And just let the brush run out of paint, really. You don't even have to connect them all the way either. Don't worry about, you know, ending that down there. You want to make sure the direction of your brush. You want to think how those original letters were probably made, going top to bottom. Ugh. Downside about outside. You know, the downside about patina too is it absorbs so much paint. This customer's logo is actually black and white, but being that this is going on a light blue truck with brown rust on it, wanted to complement the colors. I like using the tape too. It gives it a nice, clean, crisp line. Similar to how they would have done it originally. Thank you.